Hero, there's something I'd like to take a look at.
This notebook right here.
Huh? Hey, why is my name written on it?
I found it in the locker room on the second floor. If you don't mind, could you take a look inside?
Sure, whatever you want. But I've never seen this notebook before in my life.
Wizza Wizza, is something wrong?
It's kinda similar. No, even more than that. This is absolutely my handwriting, without a doubt!
That probably explains why it's so neat as well.
But how is this? I don't remember ever writing in this thing! No! No way!
It looks like you actually did attend class here at Hope's Peak, but somehow, you forgot all about it.
Lies! It's all one big lie!
I don't want to believe it either. But there's also no explanation for this pocketbook.
And whose pocketbook is that?
It's mine. And the handwriting inside is also mine. There's no doubt about it. But just like Hero, I have no memory of ever writing in it.
And the reason for that is the 2 years of missing memories?
After seeing all the evidence, do you have any choice but to acknowledge the truth?
Isn't it just so
it's a fucked up truth,
dark?
But...
The mystery solved, but it's like a goddamn funeral in here! Shit, man, I've never been to a funeral!
Oh god, I love this chick. Like half of the time.
2 years of school life. How many moments of blossoming youth have you missed out on? How many fun classes? How many school events? This was your chance to build lasting friendships, right? And on top of that, something tragically sad happened 1 year ago. The biggest, most awful, most tragic event in human history. Right before everyone's eyes, the world came crashing down. You absorbed all that despair, but then you forgot it all. And once you'd forgotten, you made the choice to subject yourselves to this killing game. Oh, and there's one other thing. To be even more precise, the memories you all lost were...
Actually, never mind. I'm bored. Explaining stuff is boring.
What?
We are bored of this world. Everyone always talks big, declaring all the great things they'll do. But then they always fizzle out. This world is just so desperately fucking boring!
What are you talking about?
This is beyond multiple personality disorders. This is...
In a way,
advanced
of all
personality
of
disorders.
To give yourself over so completely to such...
It's like each emotion has a separate brain.
Yeah, so figure out the rest for yourselves! I'm sick of expositioning all this shit!
It's a good thing too, because I'm kind of getting sick of it too.
Figure out what?
Figure out where your memories come apart. That's at the heart of all of this.
Where our memories come apart. Is she talking about the moments where we must have lost our memories? I can think of one time. I can only think of one time. Just after I set foot in the main hall for the first time, it was when I got my acceptance letter at the entrance ceremony. When I faint, it was one of these two. No. I was thinking of a different entrance ceremony. Okay. Whoops. So it's the second option then, when we were entering Hope's Peak Academy. Okay, so I fucked up again. Wait, so the last answer... When I fainted? That was... Okay, fuck it, whatever. It was like somewhere around that time, except for the... Okay, whatever.
Came to the gates of this school and stepped foot in the main hall. When I passed out, I was overcome with a strange sensation.
Okay.
So, and your sense of time got... I guess it must have been...
After I passed out,
okay,
I woke up in a classroom with my head on a desk. I assume not much time had passed since I'd collapsed in the main hall.
But instead, 2 whole years had gone by!
I don't look different for 2 years of being 2 years older.
The reason it felt so short was because... our memories of the time in between had been completely removed.
You got it, honey! 2 years of memories?
friends, of course!
When everyone met for the first time, it wasn't actually for the first time. Unaware of this fact, you took the time to introduce yourselves to each other, but...
But by that point, we'd already spent 2 years together at the school. That's what those photos reveal, isn't it?
Yep, that's what they reveal! You were all such close friends! You spent 2 years together, and then you started killing each other! And it was all so you could escape into a world that's already been annihilated! What a terribly tragic tale! Even if you left now, there's nothing you could do to fix it!
You're the one who set things up to be like this!
I love you all so much.
What?
Once your school life here began, I thought about you constantly. It's only natural that I would fall in love.
So, since I love you so much, I'll tell you all about the idea we came up with as the ultimate despair. Our plan to bring despair to all mankind.
What? All of us? Oh god, okay, explain yourself. Okay, blah blah blah. Why does it have to be this voice of all fucking things?
School life during that first year.
Okay, happiness and happiness and hope.
Oh boy, it was just the
okay. And all that too.
Was enjoying themselves so much.
Wow, so I was really wrong about Celeste being the main culprit and somehow surviving her execution, because I guess I was just my brain thinking differently, because her photoshopped pose looked exactly the same in every single thing.
But that couldn't last forever.
Thank God, holy shit, I can't stand that voice.
Only made it through that first year. Because after that, an event unfolded that hammered a soul-crushing despair into all of humanity. The biggest, most awful, most tragic event in human history. The tragedy. All too soon, the world's days of peace came to a bloody end.
Now, how this all fucking started, and the true master... Wait, what am I saying?
And as you can imagine, the school was no exception. The tragedy even made its way here, leading to the extermination of most of the students.
What are you?
Hmm? What do you mean?
The most tragic event in human history, and the ultimate despair that caused it. I can't believe it's all because of just you and Mukuro. Was it some kind of organization? An angry mob? An incredibly motivated family?
You have a point. If I had to describe it, I'd say it was none of those. How can I put it? It was more of an ideological thing.
This game is all about ideologies, holy shit.
Despair is contagious, you know? It's almost like a natural phenomenon.
A natural phenomenon? So you're saying this purge could potentially exist.
Okay. Everyone is capable of it. And now the entire world has fallen into despair.
In other words, if you see despair as the enemy, then your enemy is the world itself.
I just don't understand why.
We didn't ask you to try to understand. This was a tangent anyway, unrelated to the matter at hand.
Okay. So, let's get back to the story. Hope's Peak had taken so much damage. You guys were the only survivors. The members of the 78th class of Hope's Peak Academy were the only ones left.
And then, pay attention! So guess what? To protect everyone...
Okay, transform into a shelter, so that's why we said yes into the answer.
I said it twice!
Now, someone was responsible for that transformation. For creating what would eventually become your prison. Do any of you know who that might have been?
The headmaster of the school? The Prime Minister?
I got it! It could only have been the headmaster of Hope's Peak Academy. He wanted to turn the school into a shelter to try and protect us. To protect us from the despair and tragedy taking place outside. That's why he asked us to make that promise, to say that we were willing to live in this school forever.
Damn.
We believe he had something like that in mind, yes. If you, the collective... collective hope of a new generation could survive, maybe the world could have a fresh start.
Yeah, the headmaster put that much faith in you.
And because we had that same hope, that's why we all agreed to live here forever.
But creating the shelter was also his single biggest mistake.
Because that was like the perfect setting ground for...
It's laughable, really. He was the headmaster, but he had no idea. He had no idea that we, the ultimate despair, had already made our way into the school. So what was supposed to be a shelter to keep you safe became a cage that made it impossible for you to escape despair.
Ugh. You know, we're supposed to solve this mystery, but it seems like she's telling us all this fucking information straight out.
It took me a ton of time.
By the way, it was you yourselves who blocked off the windows, the doors, all the exits. Under the headmaster's direction, you all went about your work like obedient little sheep.
You mean we trapped ourselves in here?
And then you forgot all about it and started bitching about how you were trapped in here.
Once you'd finished building your little shelter, it was time for me and Mukuro to get to work. And thus began the killing game.
Me and Mukuro had come here, spending the last 2 years waiting for that moment.
That moment where you all began killing each other served as the climax of our global despair plan.
And the only reason you survived the tragedy was so that you could be a part of it.
And you let us live? So we could go around killing each other? Is that what you're saying?
Why? Why would you do that?
Despair.
This was so much more than a simple high school deathmatch. Rather, it was a method to hunt down and destroy every last remaining speck of hope in the world.
What are you saying?
Well, it would seem that there's a little bit left out there. A few souls unwilling to give up hope. So I thought I should show them, which is why I...
Well, why don't you tell me?
Okay, more answer explaining. What the Mastermind did to show everyone in the outside world, that was... Okay. Oh, more Hangman's Gambit. Jesus fucking Christ. Okay. Okay. It's 6 letters. Hack. Hla. Hick. Hickhack. Her. Ha. How. Who. It has to be a vowel. There's nothing that pertains from an H, so... It's either I. It is an I. Hijack? That's the only word that fits in, right? Okay, hijack.
Now I understand. You're talking about you hijacking the airwaves, aren't you?
Uh-huh. That's exactly what I'm talking about. To show the world the murders taking place at this school, which was meant to be a symbol of hope.
That was the whole point of the ultimate despair. When I said climax, that was what I was talking about. The world watched as you fell into despair and began to kill each other one after another.
Ooh.
Despair is as contagious as any disease. Any hope left turns to despair.
Isn't the power of television just amazing? By the way, since we started broadcasting, a whole bunch of people have tried to come and rescue you.
Are you serious?
But utilizing the heavy weaponry I installed around the school grounds, I had no problem expelling them.
Expelled them?
I have to thank you all. They were a relentless bunch, refusing to give up on hope and trying to force their beliefs on the world. But in the end, I was able to give them the final despair. Death.
So you just used us? To bring despair to everyone in the outside world?
Well, sure, but I also get-
Give and take? You're so full of shit!
Say more, Makoto.
There's a reason I chose you guys to survive when all the other students, I mean, we built up 2 years of memories together.
Sorry, that's a lie. I just figured you'd despair even more when you found out a friend had betrayed you.
And that's the truth, which is what you wanted, right? So, does it make make you feel utterly lost and hopeless?
Damn, all this exclamation is definitely dragging me down.
You solved the mystery, but despair at the truth, right?
Don't tell me. Did you seriously count on the possibility that we would solve your mystery?
And if we did, then what? Our final desire for creating this world of despair was so we could experience one last class trial. If you were bold enough to solve the mystery, only to discover that the truth was utterly hopeless, how would you react? What would you do?
See? Discovering the truth doesn't necessarily lead to a sense of hope.
Truth can be full of despair, too! Like right fucking now!
Truth full of despair. That's...
Not to mention, all those motives I talked about were totally meaningless. I mean, with the world having ended and all.
Meaningless? Then we've been murdering each other? For nothing?
And think about it. You chose to lock yourselves up here. Then started murdering each other to get out.
We weren't just random strangers either. We were classmates. We'd spent 2 years together.
No, even I can't laugh at that.
Okay.
We get it. We get it, okay? You're totally awesome, right? We get it already. So help us. I'll do anything. Just help me.
A peasant begging for his life? Oh, how delightful. We've never witnessed such a travesty firsthand.
But I'm sorry to say, begging doesn't work on me. All I want is despair, and there's no reason for it. And since there's no reason, there's no argument against it. There's just no understanding it. No argument, no understanding. What better definition of ultimate despair could there be?
Wait, hold on. You've just been going on about whatever you feel like, but... But there's no real reason for us to believe anything you have to say.
Huh?
You say the world's fallen apart, but I haven't seen it for myself, so I don't acknowledge it. I don't accept it as the truth.
Until you see it with your own eyes. Truth and falsehood overlap one another. In other words, you're not unlike Schrodinger's cat right now. Is that what you're saying? If so, what then?
Are you saying you won't accept? Well, you better not. Trust me, I'm not lying about it.
Well, even if it's all true, I refuse to give in. I refuse to lose to you for the sake of everyone you've killed.
Huh? What are you talking about?
I didn't kill anyone. I simply gave you a little nudge in the right direction.
And that's all it took for you to start killing each other. You're nothing but bloodthirsty animals.
That's why anyone was murdered here, peasant.
Say what you want about...
Oh, yes! That's funny as shit!
No! This isn't just some game to us. It's murder! Plain and simple! You stole our memories. Invented reasons for us to do it. You pushed us all into a corner! It's all your fault!
You certainly have a talent for passing the buck, don't you? That must be your hope. But we don't have much time left to keep up this banter. We have to draw things to a close soon.
Yeah, this cutscene's been going way too long, hasn't it? I don't think I've even, like, spoken a single line yet during this entire this part of the playthrough.
I'm talking about the vote, of course.
What? Huh?
You didn't forget about that little rule, did you?
The vote? See who those black and... Oh, God, what? Okay, so, what?
Oh, and also, since this will be the last vote, I decided to change the rules.
What?
Huh?
You guys so full of hope. And me so full of despair. I've decided to have you vote which one will be punished.
What?
If even one of you votes to punish Hope, well then, I'll consider that a win for me and punish everyone on the side of Hope.
If it's just one person?
Oh, but don't worry. I won't be voting, of course.
Even if you don't, you still got the upper hand in all this.
It's okay. Nobody would actually vote to kill themselves, right?
Oh, let me just mention one more thing. When I win, to punish you guys, you'll have to stay here till you grow old and die. No fighting, no killing. That's your punishment.
What?
You mean,
we'd have to just live here?
She's saying she'll let us live.
If you're not happy with that, then go ahead and punish me and make your way to the outside world.
This is probably gonna alter into different endings. So just in case, can I? There we go. I'm gonna make another save file. Maybe to view both endings. Alright. This could be our final decision to whatever is going to happen.
Enter a world fallen from grace, where only despair exists, where you'd likely be dead within a day.
What are you saying? So no matter what, we're doomed.
Wait a sec. I just got hit with an inspiration bomb.
Oh, what?
Dying of old age is boring as shit, right? The audience at home isn't gonna dig that at all. So here's what'll happen. One of you will get to experience an instant, super impressive punishment.
One of us.
What? You can't just...
Do you mean to say you'll execute one of us?
And I get to decide who's gonna have to suck it down. Makoto, you're...
What? Huh? Me?
Yeah, you've been acting up, causing all kinds...
So let me make this clear. Everyone has two choices in front of them. If a single person votes for Hope to be punished, then only Makoto will receive a harsh punishment, and the rest of you will live here in peace.
You guys had better be friends with me.
If, on the other hand, you desire to see us punished, then you must all leave this place.
I will force you out, ensuring you all die horrible deaths in the outside world.
What I'm saying is, if you sacrifice Makoto, the rest of you will get to live out your lives.
You piece of shit. Okay.
What? Has your resolve softened? Have you lost confidence? Are you afraid of being punished? Don't you have faith in your friend?
No, that's not it.
It's okay. You're right to be afraid. It would seem all of those around you have realized the futility of going against me.
You guys?
It's so beautiful.
I know Kyoko will stand by my side, right? She's my friend. She hasn't said...
Besides, Kyoko, you could never betray your father, could you?
What?
I mean, the headmaster's only wish was that all of you would survive, right? That's why he tried to trap you all here, after all. The least you can do is try to honor your dead father's wishes.
Kyoko, one person's despair is enough to seal your fate. Isn't that just the most hopeless outcome ever?
So, who do you think's gonna give in? Whose despair is gonna sign your death warrant?
No one. Nobody's gonna give in to despair! We're not gonna lose to you!
So boring. Stubborn till the very end, huh? Well, that's fine. Then let's just hurry up and get it over with. It's time for the final vote. Everything will come to an end. Your stupid hope.
I mean, I was friends. Does the social link aspect have anything to do with final outcome? Because it seems like I have no say in this whatsoever. So the good and bad ending, whatever it is, it's all dictated by what I did on my free time, if that's the case.
And your stupid life!
The final vote? This is it, the ultimate confrontation. I have to show everyone. I have to make them remember. I have to convince them to not give up. To live in despair? That's not really living at all! Okay. There's probably more to it than this then, huh? Make your argument. Okay, whoa, that's a lot. Okay, locker notebook, photo, Kyoko and Handmaster, Kyoko's e-handbook, group photo.
We won't give up. As long as there's hope, we'll never give up.
I'm not gonna contradict myself, am I?
That would be the end of Hope's Peak Academy.
Can I convince him?
By the way, the air outside is totally polluted, you know. The only reason we're okay in here is thanks to the air purifiers in the physics lab.
Oof.
If I die, the purifiers will screech to a halt. In other words, as soon as I die, the communal life you've all been living will come to an end.
Meh. Meh. She's like, I don't care.
All of you will have to leave. You'll have to go into the world outside, where only death and despair are waiting.
Oh no.
So, what are you gonna do? Will you just die? Is that what you want?
She doesn't even have an option. If I... Whoa, okay. If I don't do something, everyone's gonna be consumed by despair. You claim there's no hope left in the world. But if despair is contagious, like you say, then so is hope. I'll use my own hope to plant seeds of hope inside everyone else. Okay.
We won't give up. As long as there's hope, we'll never give up.
Am I gonna contradict myself? Okay, that's not it.
That would be the end of Hope's Peak Academy.
Okay, Headmaster E handbook, locker notebook. Wait. Locker notebook, or look, is it? What was it called? Pocketbook. What's it say? Pocketbook was found in the locker on second floor of the dorms, and based on what was written inside, it's believed to be Kyoko's. There's some kind of message scrawled on the last page of the handbook. Despair walks among us, and so we survive. Wait. Despair walks among us, and so we survive. There's a second despair. That's kind of... am I going to contradict myself by doing that? That might be a trap. Ugh. Okay, what other evidence is there?
By the way,
group photo.
The air outside is totally polluted, you know. The only reason we're okay
group photo?
Here is thanks to the air purifiers in the physics lab.
I'm not getting... no, never mind. Okay, yeah, I'm fucked.
We won't give up! As long as there's hope, we'll never give up!
If I were to die, that would be the end of Hope's Peak Academy.
Oh my god.
By the way, the air outside is totally the only reason we're okay thanks to the air pure.
Everything else is dot dot dot. Kyoko's the only one that... Let me see if I could try... to counter... I can't. Okay, so there's no option. Okay, well, that's my last chance, although... If there is a game over after this, then... Okay, I get the bad ending, whatever. But if I get to continue, then... Well, it seems like the game just doesn't give a shit. Okay. You claim there is no hope left in the world, but if despair is contagious, like you say... Okay.
We won't give up! As long as
there's hope, we'll never give up!
If I were to die, that would be the end of Hope's Peak Academy.
You? Fuck.
Shoot.
Okay, yeah, I'm dead. I'm just curious if there actually is a game over screen or not. Failed. Despair, it did, okay. Okay, yeah, give it another try.
I refuse to give up yet.
Okay, so I have practically infinite tries here. So there's... hope. Wait a minute, I have an idea. I'll use my hope to inspire everyone else, or something. If it's not any of these, then... It's probably my hope. It can't be anyone else's dot dot dot.
We won't give up. As long as there's hope, we'll never give up.
All right, let's pull this into everyone else. Hope! Hope! Hope is the key to power.
All my fortune-telling senses are telling me not to leave this place. To live means moving forward, right?
Oh.
So even if it's hard, even if we're scared, we don't have any choice, do we? I want to keep on living. I want to open the next door. There must be something new waiting for me.
Oh.
So that's why. That's why. No matter what, I need to get out of here. The whole fortune-telling thing doesn't matter anymore. What matters is my own gut feelings.
That's the spirit, Yasuhiro.
We won't give up.
Okay, this is a clever way to inspire hope to everyone. Yeah! You shut the fuck up about your air pollution. We got our natural lungs, bitch!
What would Sakura do? You only get stronger by taking adversity by the horns. Confront that thorny path with enthusiasm.
Oh, fuck yeah. Let's give hope on this motherfucking bitch! Friendship is magic, motherfuckers!
Which is why I've made up my mind.
We won't give up. As long as there's hope, we'll never give up.
I decided to have faith in myself.
By the way, the air is the only reason we're up here.
Thanks to the air purifiers in the fist.
Say whatever you want. I've made my decision.
As soon as I have a communal life.
And then I want to know what she's gonna say. Aside from meh. Okay. I can't believe I'm saying this to Genocide Jill, but alright, I'll just do it.
I don't care either way. I'm fine with whichever one is more.
I guess, okay.
Actually, I may not look like it. I always hated school. Hell, no matter how I look, still hate it. But no matter what, Master has to come along with it.
Okay. Okay. Oh, no, 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 no! Oh, fuck me! Where's the hope for everyone else? God damn it! Ugh, I missed the hope. I was fast-forwarding too much. Okay. Okay, yeah, I fucked up. Whoops. You're getting your turn later soon, dude. Although, Kyoko, that's the one part I'm really concerned with. Although, I do have majority vote. No, 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 it's gonna be a tie. Wait, no, I still have majority vote. It doesn't matter what Kyoko and Byakuya says, because we still have majority hope, right? Majority, even if they might not like it. Okay, fuck it.
As long as there's hope, we'll never give up.
There we go. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Come on, Byakuya. Come on, Byakuya. I'm gonna give you a hope. A fucking hope. No more hope of despair. More hope, bitch! Okay, here we go. Byakuya, here's more hope. Come on, dude. You're my buddy, right? We may have different agreements, but come on.
What's the matter? You're not actually trying to encourage me, are you? Ridiculous. It never even crossed my mind that I might give in to despair.
Oh.
But don't misunderstand me. I couldn't care in the slightest what happens to you. I just have to keep my word. I swore I would end the life of the mastermind.
Oh.
Besides, the Togami family isn't dead. Because I'm still alive. So until I can restore the Togami family and bring it greater glory than it's ever known,
we won't give up. As long as there's hope, we'll never give up.
If I were to die, that would be the end of it.
Wait, is this a trick question? Do I have to give the picture of the freaking?
By the way, the arrow is totally the only reason we're up here. Thanks to the air purifiers. You can say whatever you want. If I die, the air is another way.
I already said I would claim the mastermind's life by whatever means necessary.
All right.
So, what are you gonna do? Will you just die? Is that what you?
Don't lose hope now.
I didn't really know my father, so I can't pretend to know what he was thinking. But even if we're just connected by blood, there's one thing I am sure of. He would never want us to abandon Makoto and choose to stay here. I can't explain why exactly. But if I'm sure of anything, I'm sure of that. Just because we don't actually know anything, does that mean we can't understand? Could it be that? No, never mind. So, Makoto, I don't think you wound up at this school because you had good luck or bad luck. I think you came here for a different reason entirely. You came here to bring down the ultimate despair.
What, am I the god or messiah of this world?
Here to confront despair.
Holy shit, that makes me Neo.
Up. And if that's true, I think we could call you the ultimate hope. What do you think?
What the hell are you?
Oh yeah, the ultimate hope has been added to the true bullet on my own handbook. Is this gonna be the rhythm game again?
Your stupid faces, the stupid things you've said, the stupid way you all treat each other. It's all so uncool, so unhip.
That's something that a hipster would say. Oh, show, holy fuck, 35 minutes. I'll need to take a quick break and stay tuned for quite possibly the finale, maybe? Who knows? Stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen.